Good morning, friends. This is time for the trade plan for 10th of August 2020. First of all, some announcements that both English webinar on 22nd of August and the Hindi webinar on 29th of August are now open for registrations. We have received a lot of support from all of you, and those who have made the payment have been sent our brochure with the course content. So make sure that you are in before we hit our limit. Our limit is about 100 in each one of those webinars. So people need to register quickly, because to have a second webinar, we will again need to have 100 people. So I think you need to move in fast. For those who don't have the contact information, please WhatsApp to 9871066337. That is 9871066337. Or email at ashwani_gujral@yahoo.com. ashwani_gujral@yahoo.com. So these announcements are being done. Let's see what we should anticipate today. I think what is relevant for the day is that we are still in a range. And the issue with ranges is that till they break out, they can continue to move sideways. Let's open the Nifty chart here. We have the market which is contracting, as you can see, for last couple of days. Plus, we have a very, very narrow range situation. Now, in a market which is overall in a ranging situation, plus where you are getting a bit of narrow range bars, I put more store in the range boundaries. These narrow range bars may not actually have the same impact like this bar here. This narrow range bar occurred in an ongoing uptrend. So here the implication is very different from the implication that you may have here. Here, I think the boundaries are more relevant. So I would look for the boundaries to get crossed before serious short covering comes in. So the boundaries remain 10,900 to about 11,350. Okay, so the good news is that the Bank Nifty is showing some amount of resilience. So for the day, I am still a buyer at this lower end, which is 11,150. So this is in syllabus for me. If a breakout happens and we are hitting upper boundaries, that may not work out too well unless we start to get follow through beyond the boundary. So this you should keep in mind, that while a breakout is imminent, just breaking out of Friday's range may not be enough. So what we want the market to do is get past at least 11,300. Okay. Similarly, Bank Nifty again three narrow range bars. So it is likely that because of this AGR case, etc., coming in, some of the banks could push this market higher, and the immediate resistance is this 22,400 zone. Okay, so this sort of zone is likely. So once we get past this, you could have a bit more upside, and maybe you could get back all the way to this area. The odds of it breaking below 21,000 have reduced a lot. But again, if you ask me, I am interested in buying at 21,500, 600 if we get there. So the idea remains buy on dip, because that is a safer buying area. For a breakout, you need some kind of trigger. And the breakout should happen basically beyond this narrow range, and on the Nifty beyond the range of the Nifty on the upside, which is 11,300, broadly. Okay, so the sort of sectors or stocks we want to look at. Now, IndusInd Bank, in my opinion, could move up given the AGR news that is coming in. So this is something you can look at for the day. This had this sharp move, kind of corrected back. So somewhere in this area around 500, 505, it could have a good buying area, and you could easily get 525, 530. Similarly, this is UPL. UPL had this big red bar, which is almost getting cleaned out by green. And this is the 200-day moving average. So, post the open, if we get anything closer to, say, 470, 75, these will be good areas to get into UPL. On the daily chart also, if you see, there is support in this 470 type of area. So both on daily and intraday, UPL is looking good. On the other hand, if stocks like metals, etc., they correct, they should be looked at, because the stimulus is on the way, and this is Hindalco. Big green bar, narrow range bars, and anytime we start to break 179 on the upside, there could be more continuation here. So on a 5-minute chart, this has kind of come off. The 200 period average here is about 176. So the idea is, if it resumes its upside beyond 179, that would be the place where you want to get into a Hindalco. That should be it for the day. I hope you have a good trading day, and please register for the webinars if you do want to attend, because seats are running out fairly quickly, and you should have your brochure as soon as you make the payment. Again, repeat, dates for English webinar are 22nd of August, and for the Hindi webinar is 29th of August. If you cannot attend on either of these dates and you want the next date, you can still register, and whenever we have the next webinar, we will let you know. So that way, this sort of dialogue should continue, so that nobody misses out. This will be an extremely useful webinar. It's a collection of simple techniques that we have developed over the years, and as a toolbox, it will greatly benefit people. Take care, trade well, and please consult your financial advisor.